very tedious and very time-consuming. If you have more than even 100 images, then this is not possible for you to do this in a very efficient time. Not to say that if you have more than 10,000 millions of images. So we need to do this automatically. So that's why we need a map app or something, or the programming language. So let's move this back to the folders and delete this one. Okay. And if you have a map app, I will suggest you to just open the code I gave you in these zip files. So in this case, you can find a file called the sorting files here. So because I have only 10 minutes left, so I will try to explain the code here. So in the first line, you will see the first thing I need to read information from the label Excel files. And the command I use is SLS read. It means I want to read Excel files from this file name, which is label.xlsx. And the output is in the left. So you can see that output equal to something of the input. So the output here is the numbers and text and raw data. So we can do this just very quickly here. Let me clean up all my data in my left. So if I just copy this line and try to execute in my command windows, then you will see it will return the three outputs here. The first one is the number, which is the codings of the images. And the second one is the raw data. If you double click the raw data, it will just show you what you I've seen in the Excel file. The first column is the file name, the second column is the codings. And the other variable is the text. So in this command, you will just divide the data into the number and the text. But you can access the number and text in the different variables. So the next one is just like what I did in I manually created this in this folders, is make a directory. So in the MATLAB, to make a directory, you will use the mkdir, which is an abbreviation for the make directory. So mkdir is just trying to create two folders in this current directory. So when you execute these two lines, you will immediately see the two folders has been created by these two commands. But inside the folder, there's nothing, okay? So our task is try to identify which files should go to folder 0 or which file should go to folder 1. And to do this, we need to read all files in these folders into our MATLAB workspace. So to do this, we need to use a function called the dir, which is abbreviation for directory. So for this command, you will find out all the DICOM files in this directory. So in the right column, you will see the files which contains 10 files information. If you double click on this one, then you will see there are names, folders, dates, files, other information here. But the most important here is the name. So we need to use this name information to compare with the Excel information, right? So we will know which one is pneumonia, which one is not. The next one is that we just make this task in a repeated way. So to do a repeated task in the MATLAB, we need to use a for loop. So anybody knows for loop? Yeah, somebody might know. But for those who are not familiar with programming, is a very useful feature in a programming language. So we can specify the task we want to do in the computer and just let it do over and over again. But the difference is that for each loop, a variable will change over time. So for example here, I will change the variable I from 1 to 10. So we will just like the loop goes from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and until the 10. So in this loop, we'll do two things. The first test is I want to know whether or not this file M is corresponding to the normal or pneumonia. So we need to find the index of these the files. And to do this, we need to compare two file names. The one file name is from the directory. The other file name information is from Excel. So in Excel, if we find the certain files in this Excel information, then we will look into the right and see what number associated with this file. Then we will know that this file is normal or not. So the right side, this command, you just do this kind of job. And how do I do this? I just do the string comparisons. So this may be a little bit complicated for some of you, but I just want you to know that try to find out, try to read this code and try to understand the meaning. So suppose that we find this file is normal or not, then the next thing is try to copy the file into the corresponding directory. So you can just write two lines to complete this job. So just let me just execute this the six lines of code. It's very quick. So now you just move into the zero, and you already see that there are five files here, and look into the other folder, you will see also five files in that folder. So you don't have to do this manually, but just use a simple few lines of code, you can complete a very complex job. So you have 10,000 images, you can do this in a very quick way. So that is a dirty work, but I just wanted to show you how to automize this kind of work. So I think you already have this course, so you can learn how to use this course in your data. But because of time limitations, I want to jump into the most important one. Probably most of you want to know what you are going to present in the case presentation one. So for the case presentation one, because we only learn about like the regression model, we learn about like the random forest, we learn about like SVM. So these methods are based on the features data. So for example, if you have imaging data, that is the raw data, which is it's not just not number based, it's like intensity, just like you see in the pneumonia chest X-ray images. But for the trend imaging data, we can also get some features from our brain, like the brain dollars. So we can divide the brain into different areas and calculate the brain dollars in each brain region. So we have a very nice data set, which is there's no IRP problems here, and I can release to all of you, which is from Harvard Medical School. We have 1,200 cases of the imaging data, but we have already computed the brain balance for each case. And in this data, we have 600 male and 600 female. So the question is that, can you use this data to classify the male and female? I think this data is more meaningful than the fundacy image, because in the brain, we know that there's difference between the male and female. So I welcome you to download the data, and every group will acquire just 200 male and 200 female. So every group will have a little bit different data, but do the same task. And I need to emphasize that don't pursue the best accuracy in this case. The goal is to try everyone to understand how to do the work. not to compare the result from group to group, okay? So our scoring criteria does not include the accuracy. We just try want everyone to understand how to do the machine learning. Okay, so I will let Steve to help you to get the relevant data in this data set. Okay? So any questions? Yeah. Sorry, we do have limited time in this second half of course. So I hope I can have more time to explain the meta code. But in the next few course, I will try to elaborate more. Okay. Any questions? Well, as I said, you can ask in Chinese. It's no problem. 有没有什么中文的问题可以让我们 OK. Sorry, let me use Chinese for a little bit. 就是这堂课的目的就是说，希望大家可以先了解一下我们怎么样准备我们这个机器学习的资料。 所以我们必须要把这些资料有很好的这个结构性的安排，那后面的东西就会变得比较直接、比较简单。所以会需要用一点点小小的程式来做这件事情。那我希望大家回去还是可以多看一下这个 meta code， 去了解一下里面每秒代表什么意思。OK， 好，Thank you very much。
Haven't received any email from me so far, please come to me and leave your email to me because I will send the grouping information.
Okay.
他问一下最后那个，
我在选，
我讲过你好。